In Gloucester, Massachusetts, a city built on the edge of the sea, fishing has always been more than just a job, it's a way of life.
My grandmother and my mother would say that you could actually walk across the harbor, just walking across the different fishing boats from one side to the other, because so many were docked here.
For centuries, in America's oldest seaport, the docks were bustling, boats packed hull to hull.
When my dad fished, there was about 350 boats in the harbor. Now I think we're at about 12 real ground fishing boats and a lot of lobster boats.
Overfishing, new regulations, and climate change began to reshape the industry. But from that very same working waterfront that once launched schooners and salted cod came a new kind of vessel. This time it's one of science and innovation.
We're always looking for different ways to find an industry that's compatible with the fishing industry. And so when the opportunity came along to mesh biotechnology and fisheries together, it was a win-win.
The Gloucester Marine Genomics Institute, or GMGI for short, is a nonprofit on the cutting edge of marine biotechnology. Inside the Aqua Room, scientists are studying sea urchins.
So it's been a very humbling lesson to learn that the genetic makeup of the sea urchin is very similar to the genetic makeup of a human.
These spiny creatures hold fascinating clues about aging and illness resistance.
We're using them as a model to understand healthy aging, and more importantly, how these 200-year-old animals avoid degenerative diseases and cancer.
But these scientists don't work alone.
This is a laboratory at sea.
GMGI has joined forces with Gloucester local Tom Hill, a longtime fisherman who knows his way around the water.
I started fishing in the mid-70s, and then I fished off and on for the last 40.
Tom, along with a team of scientists, ventures out to Stellwagen Bank every quarter to collect various samples.
We're using what's called environmental DNA to try to understand everything that's in the water, from the tiniest single-celled organism up to a whale, and catalog that over time.
They use tools to collect sediment and water from multiple checkpoints. Tom using his lobster pot hauler to bring the tools back to the boat.
This is called a Van Veen grab. Essentially drop it over the side of the boat, lands onto the sediment, this releases, we pull it up and it scoops out a piece of the bottom of the ocean. Next we're going to collect our water samples, and we take samples both at the surface and bottom.
His decades of fishing knowledge merging with scientific discovery.
Any solid science that's going to help the fishery managers make good decisions that affect the fishing industry and a lot of people's lives, you want to be part of it. And you want to make sure that everything is done properly and that they get the best available science.
But GMGI doesn't stop there.
A lot of children in fishing families would just go into the next generation of the fishing family. We were looking for an industry that would be compatible, but also offer that ability to work with your hands.
Just down the road at Gloucester Biotechnology Academy is a life-changing training program that opens doors for recent high school graduates and adults alike.
We have three basic skill sets they train on: molecular biology, which is all DNA work, cell culture, both microbial and mammalian cell culture, and biomanufacturing are the three skill sets they learn.
Madeline Harlan, who went from student to teacher, says this academy reshaped her future.
I'm one of the kind of rare stories of students who turn up without any idea what they're getting themselves into, didn't know what biotech was, and, you know, 9 months later I had a job and a career.
The 9-month program ends with a paid 3-month internship at one of the many biotech companies throughout Massachusetts.
We get these young people on a career path.
But Education Director John Doyle says students are coming away from this program with much more.
It's incredibly gratifying work to see these guys do well. The essence of the program is it's a confidence program. It's a confidence course. I mean, you really see them blossom, so to speak, in the field.
And for the last 3 years, all students have been able to attend tuition-free thanks to a prestigious grant the Academy secured. The Academy also offers a summer STEM program for students in middle and high school. It's a 1-week program that introduces students to the biotech world. More information about that on our website.